from downtown Main Street. It's Disney's House of Mouse.
Start knocking at the House of Mouse. We're all knocking at the House of Mouse. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're all rocking at the House of Mouse. We're having a ball and rocking the hall. So come on in,
to the House of Mouse.
So come on in, the good times are all just about to begin. Step inside, we're gonna have some fun. There's plenty of room here for everyone.
Gang's all here and we're hanging out.
All this fun makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you.
We'll find so many things to do.
So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball
at the House of Mouse.
And now, Miska, Muska, Mickey Mouse!
Hey, everybody! Say, have you been following this? Seems Cruella de Vil has been a little sloppy with her driving lately.
Ooh, me?
Yeah, she's gotten 101 citations! Who was that?
Right here, Mouse!
Pinocchio, we really shouldn't be here with these fellas. They're a bad influence.
Who asked you, you nosy bug?
Jiminy!
Bye-bye, fly.
You boys mind if I continue?
Yeah, actually. It's cruel and unusual punishment. Good one, huh, kid?
Well, yeah, I guess so.
Hear that, Mickey? And it must be true, because his nose ain't growing.
I didn't say that. Mickey's my friend.
Relax. No conscience on your shoulder now.
Yeah, you got termites funnier than him.
Jiminy, how could you let Pinocchio hang out with the wrong crowd? Why, you're his conscience.
Not anymore. I tried to get him away from those hooligans, but pow! I got flicked away like a piece of land.
Gee, that's rough.
I expected Pinocchio to stick up for me, to say, knock it off, you guys. Jiminy's my conscience. But did he do that? No, siree. Mickey, I must be the worst conscience in the world.
Gosh, I wish I could help.
Mickey Mouse, your wish is granted.
Huh?
Your wish to help. You can help by being Jiminy's new client.
Oh, I don't need a conscience. I'm Mickey Mouse.
Your wish is already granted. Sign.
Don't you worry, boss. As your new official conscience, I won't mess up like I did with Pinocchio. Your morals and ethics are going to be razor straight and twice as sharp.
Oh, boy. Now, here's a really great cartoon starring me.
Now, Mickey, don't be so conceited.
Okay, here's a cartoon I happen to be in.
No. Now you're diminishing the contributions of the rest of the crew.
Fine. Here's a cartoon. Somebody lost an envelope. Maybe their name's inside. Well, nobody around. Finders, keepers. Minnie?
Hi, Mickey. You look nice. Come on in.
Gia, you look a little down. Is something wrong?
Well, earlier today I...
Oh, save it. I've got something that'll cheer you up. Ta-da!
Oh, Mickey, you shouldn't have.
Go on. Open it.
Wow! A diamond-studded hair bow! Here, hold it for a second. Okay.
Only the best for my gal. Now, what were you saying happened earlier?
Oh, Mickey, it's awful. I lost an envelope full of money.
You did? Oh, I mean, you did?
It's the charity fund for the orphanage.
Charity fund?
If I don't find it, the children will go without Thanksgiving dinner.
Oh, gosh.
And there will be no Christmas presents this year.
Gee.
Plus, the heat will be shut off and the furniture repossessed.
Ouch.
And they won't be able to pay the mortgage either, so the county will board the place up and all the orphans will be forced onto the streets left to beg for pennies from strangers just to buy a stale crust of bread.
I see.
But there's still hope. Hope that someone honorable will find the money and turn it in. Someone like you, Mickey. Someone honest and true-hearted and upright and good and...
Yeah, I get the idea.
Maybe you should go out and look for it. Maybe I just dropped it on the sidewalk somewhere. Wouldn't that be funny?
Yeah, a real hoot.
I'll wait here in case somebody calls. You go out and look for the money.
Minnie,
Thanks, Mickey. You're the best.
Gosh, I've got to get Minnie's bow back so I can get Minnie's money back. But how am I going to do it without her knowing? Ajax Curtain Cleaners, we clean curtains.
But I don't need my curtains cleaned.
That's what most average homeowners think. Do you realize how much hypothetical micropollinated sporophytes are found in your curtains?
Huh?
Take a closer look. Say, me and my monkey come to play for you. You like a good, yes? Maybe you have something to give a hungry organ grinder and his little flippy-floppy monkey?
Roo, roo.
Oh, he says he likes your hairball.
That's Pluto.
Huh? No. His name is Saturn. I can properly tie that bow for you. Got the arrows. All I need is the bow. Juggle your bow. Hair bows are a health risk.
Hiya, Minnie. Seen Mickey?
What are you?
Never mind. Come on, Saturn. We're never gonna get that bow back. I know what I've gotta do. I found the money on the ground, and I know I shouldn't have, but I used the money to buy you that bow. Now I need it back so I can get the orphan's money back.
But Mickey, I don't have the bow anymore.
What?
I just sold it and gave the money to the orphanage.
Wait a minute. If you knew all along, then why'd you make me go through all the fuss?
I just wanted to teach you a lesson.
Oh, Minnie. You're the greatest. Jiminy, listen. I know what the Blue Fairy said, but you can't be my conscience. Well, I can't have you interrupting me while I'm doing the show.
Now, you listen to me, Mr. Mouse. Pinocchio said the same thing to me at first, but I'm not letting you go down that road. No siree. As your conscience, I can't allow you to fire your conscience.
Jiminy!
Hey, Splinterhead! You're not looking for that goody two-shoes cricket, are you? Good, because that windbag conscience teamed up with Mickey.
Mickey? But Jiminy's my conscience.
Not anymore. Time to move on, kid. Leave behind that annoying insect looking over your shoulder 24/7. You're free. Come on, let's celebrate.
But I like what I wear now.
Since I'm your conscience, I think it's time for you to change your image. You need to be more conservative.
Well, at least I've got no strings.
Jiminy never let you do that.
I can see why.
Hey, ladies, looking good. Ah, my nose!
Let's blow this popsicle stand and go have some real fun.
Gee, fellas, I don't know. I need to find... Jiminy? But I guess Jiminy just doesn't need me.
Daisy, where's Pinocchio? I gotta get him to take Jiminy back.
Oh, you just missed him. What's the emergency?
Oh, Mickey, there you are.
Oh, he is. Now it's time to check out a really great cartoon. Okay, well, it's pretty good. Oh, all right. It's okay for what it is. Your chariot awaits, m'lady, for a romantic drive up the coast. Just the two of us, all alone, to watch the sunset.
Oh, Mickey, I've been looking forward to this all week.
Isn't it just perfect?
Uh-huh.
Just you and me in the open road and Daisy.
Hi. I hope you don't mind that I came over without calling.
I never minded it before.
Well, I didn't have a thing to do, so I thought I'll do something with Minnie and Mickey so my day won't be completely ruined.
Actually, Daisy, Minnie and I were planning to go for a drive.
What a wonderful idea. I'd love to join you.
Mickey, you have to be very clear when you tell her no. Otherwise, she'll mix your words around.
Saya, Daisy, I was thinking it would just be Minnie and me.
I know. And then I showed up to make it a party.
I packed a picnic for two.
How thoughtful. Enough for Minnie and me.
We're going to see the sunset. It's kind of romantic.
Oh, should I ask Donald to come?
No, it's a date.
It sure is.
Oh, what a shame. Look, Mickey's car only holds two people.
But your car holds four people.
Well, I'm sure it'll be okay. Maybe for once she'll be quiet.
Looky, Mammoth Hot Springs, the world's largest source of natural gas. They haven't met my uncle. Maximum speed limit 65. Hear that, Mickey? You're allowed to go 65 miles per hour. School zone! Hey! Slow down, Mickey! It's a school zone, for Pete's sake! Artwork crossing! Oh, look! Broccoli farm! Get the yards! Don't you just love broccoli? Broccoli farm, 25 yards! I love broccoli! Broccoli farm, 10 yards! Broccoli, broccoli, broccoli! Broccoli farm, 5 yards! Oh, they're closed.
Daisy, do you have to read all the signs?
I don't have to. I like to. Possum crossing zone!
Look, Daisy!
How can I look when your ears are in the way? You're blocking my view of the mountains. And Minnie, you need to move too. I can't feel the air conditioning.
Now, Daisy,
Punch Buggy, Arkansas!
Ow! What was that for?
We're playing Punch Buggy. Whoever sees an out-of-state plate first gets to punch someone else. Punch Buggy, Florida!
Oh.
Mississippi!
Ow!
Delaware!
Oh.
North Carolina!
Hey!
Oklahoma!
Whoa!
France!
Daisy, let's play the quiet game. That's where we see who can go the longest without making any noise.
Well, okay.
For making good time.
Stop the car! Cats! Well, what are you waiting for? Let's go, go, go!
It's time I said something. Say, Daisy, I'm sorry, but, well, it's just that Minnie and I had hoped to spend today enjoying the drive.
Don't worry. I can take a hint. If you wanted me to drive, you should have just said so. You two just enjoy yourselves. Oh, dear, my phone's getting droopy. Daisy!
You can't see! Oh, my gosh! Watch out for the birds! Hey, look out! Kite!
Doing.
We already got the nuts. Look out! Daisy!
You'll have to say that again. I didn't hear you. Some people are being rude. Look yellow to me.
I think it's flooded.
No backseat drivers.
Uh-oh.
Daisy!
That's it. I'm turning this car around. You make me ride in the back. Then you make me drive. And now this!
Oh, that does it! Now, Daisy, we didn't invite you on this drive. In fact, we've been trying to tell you all day. We want to be alone, you know, to see the sunset. Alone, as in, without you! Am I clear? We want to be alone! Jack Skywriting, get to work! Sorry, Daisy.
That's how it is.
You want to be alone? No problem. Well, we're alone.
Sunset. I'm telling you, Minnie, we gotta do something about this.
Don't slouch.
The problem is, he's Pinocchio's conscience, not yours.
We just need a way for Jiminy to realize that.
Me? Perform? Why, I wouldn't know what to do.
Why not let your conscience be your guide?
And now, Jiminy Cricket!
Ladies and gentlemen of the House of Mouse, don't be a fool. No siree. Here's how to live to be 103. Always let your conscience be your guide. I will demonstrate this advice now. Savor your youth and beauty, because wicked queens, mean stepsisters, and evil witches will try to steal them from you every time. That reminds me, don't eat apples unless you know where they came from. Avoid anyone who has a fiendish cackle, a sinister smile, or a diabolical glare, not necessarily in that order. Never sell your voice to a giant sea witch just because you have a crush on some guy. It's just not worth it. When selecting footwear for the big dance, go ahead and write your name in your shoes. There is nothing to see in the elephant graveyard. End of story. If your first name is Sleeping and your last name is Beauty, don't use a spinning wheel. Go out and buy a sewing machine. And hey, don't steal bread. Maybe you'll meet someone special, maybe you won't. Maybe you'll have puppies, maybe you won't. Maybe you'll join the circus and learn to fly. Live in the jungle once, but leave before it makes you hard. Live in the forest once, but leave before it makes you soft. Treat your elders with respect, and don't be fooled by bad advice. if a guy named Foul Fellow invites you to a place called Pleasure Island, don't go. I mean, he's got the word foul right in his name. But trust me on the conscience thing.
Oh, I want you to be my trainer instead of Phil.
No, I want you to be my monkey instead of Abu.
I'd like to talk to you about a coat I'm making.
No, come with me.
Knock it off, you guys. Jiminy's my conscience.
Now that's what I wanted him to say.
Oh, gross.
A heartfelt moment.
You call that magic? Hades is much worse.
Okay, Mike, take us out of here.
Temporary employment services for the House of Mouse provided by...
Pain! And panic. Wreaking havoc is our business.
We can turn gods mortal.
And we can copy Colate and Staple.
No! Watch it!
You've tried the worst.
Now try the curse.
We guarantee not to fail.
Not a guarantee. Pain and panic may fail.
That's it, everybody. See you real soon.
It's your old pal Goofy here. And did you know that the walls behind me are called scenery? Yep, and they're also made out of flats. I guess they're called that because, well, they're flat. And if they fall on your nose like this, wow, your nose will be flat too. Gosh, I think I better get some ice. Bye.